गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, माई सेल्फ नेम पी एस तिवारी फ्रॉम एल पी सवानी विद्या भवन। वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सब्जेक्ट ओसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ कॉमर्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट। यस, गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर चिल्ड्रन। नाउ चिल्ड्रन विल कंटिन्यू विद द न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 5, फॉर्म्स ऑफ बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन 1. At the glance point, today we'll discuss in this video sole proprietorship's meaning, characteristic, advantages and disadvantages. So let's get started. Now children, introduction about sole proprietorship. Along with the time, the need of man has increased and become varied. Man become incapable to satisfy his need by himself, so he needed the help of other people. Thus, the trading activity began through barter system. Therefore, a class of people came into existence in the society who started spending time and energy to satisfy the need of people by exchange activity of the goods, services and money. This class was called traders. For activities of purchase and sell, they introduce a different arrangement. Thus, different forms of business organizations such as sole proprietorship, partnership, HUF, that is Hindu Undivided Family, cooperative society and joint stock companies came into the existence one after the other. So all these things we'll learn in this chapter. In detail, we'll do the same. Today, we'll continue with the sole proprietorship. Sole proprietorship, children. The form of sole proprietorship is the oldest and simple than other form of business organization. This form came into the existence right from the beginning of trading. In rapidly changing world, various forms of business came into the existence and got developed. But this oldest and simple form of system is still in the existence. Still it is used to with. Now, meaning for the sole proprietor. Sole proprietorship is such a form in which the firm is owned, managed and controlled by one person. Sole proprietorship, meanwhile, the firm owned, managed and controlled by a single person. Only one person invests capital, starts and develops business and look after the activity of the business like related with the purchase, sale and the result of business such as profit, loss are borne by him only. Because he is the single person who owned, managed and controlled the firm. Similarly, whatever is the profit, whatever is the loss, borne by him. According to the Lewis and Henry, sole proprietorship is such a form of business organization in which there is only one person at the top who is responsible, who directs activity of the business and bears the risk of failure only by himself. This definition will ask in your exam also. This definition will ask in your exam, which is given by the Lewis and Henry. A single person is responsible for the whole activity. Whatever is the risk of failure is borne by himself. From the definition, one can understand that a lone trader or a sole proprietor is the only and wholly responsible. Whole business is carried out under his direction. The risk of business like loss or insolvency rests on him, shoulder only. His shoulder, all the responsibility are stand and he had to take care for the same. Thus, we can say that how it is useful and how a single person holding the full organization. Yes, children, characteristic for sole proprietorship. Here it is. First one, easy to establish. The process of establishing the sole proprietorship firm is very easy. Complexity of law do not affect. Any person can start lawful trading at any place of his liking. So the establishment part is easy. The decision is there in the hand of single hand. So establishment procedure is easy. Second one, capital. In the sole proprietorship, the owner himself invests the capital. If he finds the capital insufficient, then he can run business by borrowed money also. A single person has to invest the capital in his firm. In case it is not sufficient, he can borrow from any financial company. The owner himself is responsible to return this borrowed money. The owner is responsible to pay the debt. Third one, power of administration. Sole proprietor himself is the administrator of the business. Generally, the owner himself look after the purchase, sale, collection, accounting work and other activity. He himself is the owner of the business and he himself is the manager. If needed, then help can be taken from the member of the family, relatives or the salaried person. In case required any information, advice, etc., they can take help from their friend, family, relatives or any other salaried person who works under them. Fine. Thus, we can say that these are the three characteristics of sole proprietorship. Then fourth one, freedom of work and quick decision. Sole proprietor has freedom regarding the business. He performs the activity of business with his intelligence and experience. Under total freedom and as he is himself is the owner, he can take quick decision with ease. They are free to do work. They are free to take any kind of decision. Full freedom is there in their hand. Fifth point, liability. Liability for payment of debt is unlimited for the sole proprietorship. Because unlimited liability means that for payment of debt, the creditor can put claim on the personal property of the sole proprietor in the court of law. The other words, it can be said that when sole proprietor incur loss in the business, debt go on increasing, and for payment of debt, if there are insufficient fund in the business, then sole proprietor is liable to pay the total debt from his personal property. That is why we can say that liability is unlimited in sole proprietorship. In case they are not liable to pay the debt, they have to sell their personal property as well. Then sixth one, maintenance of secrecy. In sole proprietorship, as the trader is the sole owner of the business, the secrecy is maintained. They are not supposed to share with anyone else, and he is the single person who owned, managed and controlled. So secrecy can be maintained in sole proprietorship. Seventh one, personal contact. In sole proprietorship, as working area of business is limited, personal contact with customer can be maintained. By keeping focus on the changing taste of customer, the requirement, fashion, demand, etc., more satisfaction can be given to the customer. They are directly contacting to the customer, so directly they can satisfy the need of customer. Then eighth one, centralization of the ownership and management. In sole proprietorship, the owner himself is the manager. Thus, there is a centralized in ownership and management. In other business organization, the owner and manager are different entities. But in sole proprietorship, ownership and management is centralized. Thus, we can say that these are the characteristics for the sole proprietorship. Now, let's see the advantages. Now, children, advantages for sole proprietorship. First one, easy establishment process. As we have discussed in characteristic also, the process of establishment of sole proprietor firm is simple. There is no need to prepare any documentation. There is no need to pass through any difficulties or complexity process of law. Therefore, any person with limited capital, uneducated or having general capabilities can start the business. as a sole proprietor. Second one, less capital. Less capital is an important characteristic and is the specific advantages of sole proprietorship. Sole proprietor can start business with less capital. If additional funds are required, then the owner can bring borrowed money and invest in the business. In case they are having less capital for the investment, then also they are capable to start the business. In case they required more fund, they can ask to their friends to invest, they can ask to their family, or even they can ask for the financial institution for the investment part. In return, they will pay the interest. Then third one, maintenance of secrecy. It is advantageous for the businessman to maintain business secrets. In sole proprietorship, as only single person, a one person has all authority, he can maintain secrecy relating to the business transaction, accounts, and the key factors of the business. As compared to the other form of business organization, in this form, secrecy is better maintained. Fourth one, quick decision. As sole proprietor is the chief decision maker regarding the matters related to the business, he can take quick decision regarding important matter of business. He can take quick decision according to the trend in the market and changing circumstances. Full authority is there in their hand, so they are free to take decision. Fifth one, personal contact. In sole proprietorship, there is a centralization in ownership of the business and management. As the owner himself act as a manager, he can maintain personal and live contact with the customer. Live contact with the customer. Employee and creditor also. So according to the changing business trend, fashion and customer preference, he can make required changes in the production and distribution system and keep his market safe. Flexibility. In sole proprietorship, the owner can make required changes according to the changing business environment. Due to quick decision and constant awareness, he can bring flexibility to business. According to the changing atmosphere, anytime they can accept the changes and work accordingly. Seventh one, less tax burden. Income of sole proprietor is the income of owner. So personal, the norms of taxation are applicable to him. Generally, as the size of the sole proprietorship is small, the income is also less. Therefore, the burden of income tax is also less. Then eighth one, less legal restriction. As compared to other form of business organization, there is less legal restriction in sole proprietorship. There is no need of approval from anybody to increase or decrease the capital. As the size of business is small, the legal restrictions are also less. Fine. Less legal restriction belongs to only sole proprietorship. Then children, limitations. Limitations of sole proprietorship. Six limitations are there. First, limited capital. Trading can be done with less capital. This is the important advantages of sole proprietorship. But this is also a limitation. After industrial revolution, the size of the business unit is getting larger. For this, raising required capital become difficult for the owner. Many times, sole proprietorship firm is not capable to purchase raw material in large quantity, big size machinery, and to have big storage facility. So this is considered as a limitation for the sole proprietorship. Then second one, unlimited liability. Sole proprietor has unlimited liability, therefore he cannot free himself from his liabilities. If the borrowings have increased over business asset and credits, then he has to sell his personal property and make payment for the business debt. In this way, the owner himself has to bear all risk of the business. That is why it is said that their liability is unlimited. Third one, short duration. When the owner of the business dies or declares insolvent or loses mental balance, the existence of the business can come to the end. Either harassed to not have the ability to run the business, then it is possible that the business gets weaker and in many cases business become to the end. If higher risk is not interested for the continuity of the business, but obvious the business get weaker, and plus in case it is not handled it become to end. Fourth one, limited work capability. In sole proprietorship, the owner is responsible to formulate the policy of business. Everybody has limitation of the working. Though he may be very intelligent, sometimes the business suffers due to his certain limitations. In modern time, the business requires different type of skills, knowledges, etc. As in sole proprietorship, the scope of exchange of idea with other is very little. The development of the business remains limited. They are not exchanging the idea with others, so the development is not increases. Then fifth one, possibility of wrong decision. Sole proprietor himself take business decision. He does not have advantages to take help from experience and specialized knowledge of others. He may be more capable and skilled, but his personal decisions sometimes may be hasty, erroneous, and tend to damage to the business. So the possibility of wrong decision also there in the sole proprietorship. Lack of advantages of large scale business. Due to limited capital, the business remains limited in the sole proprietorship. As there is an unlimited liability, the owner cannot go to the larger enterprise. As purchase and sale are on a small scale business, sole proprietor cannot avail the advantages of large scale purchase and sell. So these are the six disadvantages for the sole proprietorship. Hope so you all have understand the point of sole proprietorship, meaning, concept, introduction, characteristic, advantages and limitation. Make sure do the revision for the same, and we'll continue the rest of the point in next video. Thank you for the day, children. Bye bye.